Have you ever thought about how this packaging is called, with which you struggle when you use tablets? They are called blisters, and they are widely used in the pharmaceutical industry. In my master's thesis, I've been evaluating different alternatives to the current aluminium blister, which is used in Elanco Animal Health, a global player in the animal health business. My name is Lucas Lukin, and I would like to welcome you to this small presentation. I'm from a small village in the north of Italy, and I've done my bachelor's at the Management Center Innsbruck. After my bachelor's, I've been joining FIPTES in order to tackle the challenges of the food industry of tomorrow. As you might have already guessed from my introduction, I've been specializing in food packaging and logistics during my second year at Lund University. My master's thesis was written in collaboration with Elanco Animal Health, especially with their Global Packaging Development Department. For whom who does not know what blisters are, here on the left you can see a picture of a typical aluminium blister. Blisters are widely used in the industry and have a really good product protection. They also fulfill the other packaging requirements to a high extent. So you might think, why to change anything if they are so perfect? But actually, during a consumer survey, it was found that blisters are not really convenient for you, the consumer, and they are also hard to open. On the other side, they are not perfect from an environmental point of view because they cannot be recycled and often uses harmful substances. And actually, since their invention in the 1960s, they have not gone through any bigger change. So most probably your grandparents struggled already with the same things as you're doing today. Therefore, I've been looking into different alternatives and ways how to improve the current aluminium blister. In the end, I came up with 22 different alternatives, which have been evaluated by using expert interviews with different experts from Elanco, but also external experts. The solutions have been compared by using a packaging scorecard, and the overall score was calculated. There have been a high variability between the solutions. From the 22 different alternatives, 10 alternatives have seen as promising. These solutions are marked here in green. Solution number 7, a flexible single-dose solution, was the most promising solution. This solution is highlighted in the chart. After my stay in Elanco, the project will continue. And then hopefully you and your kids will not struggle anymore with the same things as your grandparents and parents did today. If you have any questions, please approach me. Thank you very much for the attention.